Welcome to this session, students. In this session, I will teach you the very important topic of mechanical engineering. It is one of the most important topic. From this topic, you can expect around 15 to 20 marks question in GATE examination. This is your manufacturing engineering topic, that is manufacturing science. Let me introduce you with this topic. That is manufacturing engineering. Manufacturing engineering. This is very important topic. It is also called production engineering or production. Okay. Manufacturing engineering. First, let me give you a brief introduction about the marks, about the books, and what you have to cover. Okay, the books you can use for manufacturing science or manufacturing engineering, that is Ghosh and Malik. Manufacturing science book. Ghosh and Malik manufacturing science book. This is Indian author book and the professor at IIT Kanpur, Ghosh and Malik. And second, you can use the Kalpak Jain book. It is also manufacturing technology as well as manufacturing science. Manufacturing science. Okay, as well as you have to go through the class notes. Whatever I will discuss in this topic, you have to go through all the concepts and theoretical parts. Okay, class notes, question banks problem, the GATE forum question bank you can use, and last one is a test series. You have to go through. Those who are going to appear in GATE 2020 examination, no need to study the book Ghosh and Malik and Kalpak Jain because you don't have enough time. You can go through the class notes only as well as question bank and test series. You just focus on these three. Okay. In this session, I will teach you each and every important topics. Now, if you see the marks in GATE 2000, in GATE 2017, we have 15 to 17 marks problem from manufacturing. And GATE 2018, in one of the set we have, if you compare both the sets, we have 18 to 22 marks problem from manufacturing. Now see, in a paper of 100 marks, you are having 22 marks problem from this topic. Now you can understand this topic is very important, okay? And in GATE 2019, we have so on, that is a 17 to 20 marks problem we have. Therefore, this topic is very important. You cannot neglect this topic. This is one of the major topic of mechanical engineering. Okay, whatever I will discuss, that will also be important for you in your engineering services examination in prelims as well as mains examination of engineering services. So these are the name of the books and these are the questions which comes in GATE examination from this topic. Now let me give you the basic introduction of manufacturing engineering. What is the definition of manufacturing? Actually, this manufacturing, it is made up of two words. One is manu and second one is the factors, and the meaning of manu is to make, and factus means by hand. To make something by hand, that is called manufacturing engineering. That was the ancient definitions, and the old definition that you get by breaking the word. But the actual definition of the manufacturing engineering is, actually it is a process of converting raw material or semi-finished material into a desired finished product. If you have a raw material and if you want to convert it into a finished product, like suppose this is the raw iron, a rod of iron, and you want to convert it into a plier, you want to convert it into a gear, you want to convert it into sheets, whatever your desired product, to convert it into raw material into desired product, that is called manufacturing engineering. And it can also be defined as, it is a value addition process to the raw material. To increase the market value of the raw material, that is called manufacturing engineering or manufacturing science. Let me write the definition of the manufacturing engineering or manufacturing science. See, manufacturing engineering, it is, the first definition is, it is a process of converting, it is a process of converting raw material, it is a process of converting raw material or semi-finished product into a semi-finished product into a desired product, into a desired product. So that is the basic definition of manufacturing engineering. It is a process of converting raw material into finished product or desired product. Semi-finished product into desired product or finished product. You can also write here finished product or finished product. Or finished product. So this one is your definition. Second definition you can write, it is a value addition process to the raw material so that its market value can increase. So secondly, you can define it. It is a value addition process. It is a value addition process to the raw material. Value addition process. It is a value addition process to the raw material. It is a value addition process of the raw material. Value addition process of the raw material. So these two are the basic definition of manufacturing engineering. And now the next term is the classification of manufacturing engineering. Now the manufacturing engineering is classified into four different parts. One is your metal casting, second one is your metal forming or metal working, and third one is your machining process, and fourth one is your metal joining process or welding. Third one was machining process or metal cutting process. So let me give you the classification. Now the classification of the manufacturing process. Classification of manufacturing processes. engineering or processes, because it is a process, that's why I am writing processes. Classification of manufacturing processes. Okay. Manufacturing engineering is classified into four parts. Manufacturing processes. It is classified into four parts. Let me write the first part. The first part is your metal casting. Metal casting. This is the first part. I will define each and every manufacturing process one by one. And the second one is your metal forming. This is also known as metal working. Metal forming or metal working. And the third one is your metal cutting, which is also known as machining process. Metal cutting or machining process. Metal cutting or machining process, this is the third process, and the fourth one is your metal joining process. Or welding. These are the four different manufacturing process which I will teach you one by one. So first one is the metal casting, second one is the metal forming or metal working, third one is your metal cutting or machining, and the fourth one is the metal joining process. First, see what is metal casting. In metal casting, what we will do? Firstly, we will prepare a mold with the help of a mold box and a molding sand with the help of a pattern. And a cavity is created. How a cavity is created? See, first a bottom board is used, a board which is kept on the ground, and then a molding box is kept on the bottom board. This molding box is called flask or cope, drag and chick. If your casting is very small, then one molding box is used. If the casting is big, then two molding box is used, and it is when it is very big, then three molding box is used. When two molding box is used, the upper molding box is called cope and the lower molding box is called drag. And when three molding box are used, then the intermediate molding box is called chick. Now the molding box is kept over the floor, over the bottom board. Now a pattern is kept. Suppose this is a pattern. Suppose we have to make a duster-like structure. What we will do? A pattern is made. Actually, pattern is the exact replica of final casting to be produced. Therefore, this pattern is kept here, and around this pattern, molding sand is poured. Molding sand is poured, and then ramming is done so that the molding sand get tight, and after that the pattern is shaked, and by shaking the pattern, this pattern is taken out and a cavity is created, and this whole setup is called mold. And cavity, molding sand and molding box. See, I am showing you the diagram. Suppose this is your molding box. This is your molding box, and this is your cavity. This cavity is created like this. This cavity is created, and here This is your molding sand. This one is your molding sand in the mold box. Actually, this is the top view of the mold. In top view, you will see a cavity. You will see a cavity. This is the cavity. In this cavity, liquid metal is poured. When the liquid metal is poured in this cavity, the liquid metal takes the shape of this cavity. Liquid metal takes the shape of this cavity, and then by breaking the mold, this solidified metal is taken out. Okay, so this process is called metal casting. What is this metal casting? Let me define you. It is a manufacturing process in which liquid metal is poured into a predefined mold cavity to get the desired shape. Okay, in this cavity liquid metal is poured to get the desired shape. This is called casting. Here metal casting is classified into two parts. I will discuss you one by one the classification of the metal casting, metal forming, metal cutting and metal joining process. Let me give you the classification of first, that is your metal casting. Okay. What is metal casting is classified into two parts. On the basis of mold, it is classified. Now I am classifying you the first term, that is a metal casting classification. What is this metal casting process? It is a manufacturing process in which liquid metal is poured into a predefined mold cavity to get the desired shape. Now on the basis of mold cavities, it is classified into two parts, metal casting is classified into two parts. Metal casting is classified into two parts. One is your permanent mold casting and second one is your temporary mold casting. One is your permanent mold casting. Permanent mold casting or non-expandable mold casting. Non-expandable mold casting. Second one is your temporary mold casting or expandable mold casting. Expandable mold casting. Expandable mold casting. What is this permanent mold casting? See, you will have an example of making ice in your home. Whenever you want to make ice, what you do, you just take the ice tray and pour the water in this ice tray and keep it into the fridge and you just get the ice, solidified ice. Now to make ice, you don't have to make ice tray here. Because ice tray is the permanent die, you don't have to make ice tray for every whenever you want to make ice, you don't need ice tray. Okay,
Here, permanent mold casting technique, just making ice is an example of permanent mold casting technique. But in case of sand mold casting technique, whenever you pour the liquid metal in this, suppose we have poured the liquid metal in this cavity and it gets solidified after some times, and after solidification, suppose this is a liquid metal and it gets solidified after some times like this. This is a solidified metal. To get this solidified metal out, what we will do, we will shake this metal part in this mold. Due to shaking, the sand molds breaks and this solidified casting is taken out. Since the sand mold breaks, to make a next job, to make a next product, we have to make another mold. That's why it is very it cannot be used in mass production. For a single casting, a single mold is required. Mold is a setup in which permanent, in which cavities are present, that is called mold. Actually, this setup is called mold. A molding box, this setup is called mold, in which a cavity is there, molding sand is there, molding sand is there, and this is your molding box. This is your molding box. So this setup is called mold. So whenever for a single casting one mold is required, and if in one mold, with the help of one mold, you can produce number of casting, then it is called permanent mold casting or non-expandable mold casting. Like I have given you the example of ice tray. Ice tray is a permanent mold setup. Therefore, you just have to pour only the water or pour only the liquid metal into this. You don't have to make mold every time. Okay. But the sand casting is an example of temporary mold casting. For a different casting, a different mold is required. That's why for single casting, single mold is required. Let me write here. Single casting, single mold. And here, multiple casting in single mold. You can produce multiple casting in single mold, okay? That's why it is called what? Permanent mold casting technique. Now see, the name of the permanent mold casting techniques, that is your, the first one is your C is your centrifugal casting is an example of permanent mold casting technique. This is your centrifugal casting, and the centrifugal casting, it is of three types. Centrifugal casting is of three types. The first one is your true centrifugal casting, and second one is your semi-centrifugal casting. Semi-centrifugal casting, and the last one is your centrifuging casting. Last one is your centrifuging casting. So these are the centrifugal casting is an example of permanent mold casting technique. Here, whenever I teach you next time when I start the casting, in which in detail I will discuss you the centrifugal casting. Here a permanent cylinder is present, which is rotating with omega angular speed, and liquid metal is poured like that. I will discuss you in detail. Now you just remember the name, because in objective, in one marks gate, you will have questions. Which one of the following is a permanent mold casting technique? Which one of the following is a temporary mold casting technique? You just remember the names only right now. Second one is your die casting. die casting is of two types. Die casting is of two types. One is your gravity die casting. Gravity die casting. And second one is your pressure die casting. Pressure die casting. And pressure die casting is of two types, hot chamber pressure die casting and closed chamber pressure die casting. Hot chamber pressure die casting. I am writing in short PDC, that is the pressure die casting, and the second one is your cold chamber pressure die casting. Third one is your S, that is your slush casting. That is your slush casting. And fourth one is your B, that is the blow molding. Blow molding. You must remember, later I will discuss you the application of these processes. What is the application of centrifugal casting? This casting technique is widely used to make the MCD pipes, the municipal corporation sewage pipes, gun barrels, actually the cylindrical geometry, the hollow cylindrical shapes are widely manufactured by this. By using the die casting, the aluminium piston cylinder is made by gravity die casting. Slush casting, the toys, thin gold jewelry, gold ornaments, lampshades, these items are made by slush casting. Water packaging containers, plastic bottles, these are manufactured by blow molding. So these are the classification of your blow molding. These are your classification of your permanent mold casting technique. Now come to the temporary mold casting technique or expandable mold casting technique. In this technique we have, actually I am erasing this data, hot chamber pressure die casting and cold chamber pressure die casting. Okay. I am writing it here, that is your hot chamber pressure die casting and cold chamber pressure die casting. Now, temporary mold casting technique, let me classify this temporary mold casting technique. In this, the very famous, the first casting technique is the sand casting, because sand casting, every times you have to make mold for a single casting, because here sand is used. And second one is your investment casting, because here wax pattern is used, and in each and every casting technique the wax get melted. That's why next time the you have to again make the wax pattern. That's why it is expandable mold or temporary mold casting technique. And the third one is your full molding technique. It is also known as evaporating pattern molding. Evaporating pattern molding, or it is known as cavity less molding. Three names it has, cavity less molding. And the last one is your shell molding technique. Sand casting, investment casting, full molding, evaporating pattern molding, or cavity less molding, shell molding. So these are the classification of metal casting on the basis of types of mold. I hope you guys have understood the concepts, how the metal casting is classified. So you can whenever you see your question bank, the one question is there, which one of the following is a type of permanent mold casting technique, and second one, which one of the following is a type of permanent mold casting technique. Now let me classify the metal forming technology, that is metal working, the second manufacturing processes. Metal forming, what is metal forming? It is a manufacturing process in which the desired shape of the material is obtained by plastically deforming the material, by permanent deforming the material, by plastically deforming or permanent deforming the material. See, the second discussion is your classification of metal forming process. Metal forming is classified into two parts. What is metal forming or what is metal working? Metal working, metal forming. Actually, metal forming, it is a manufacturing process in which the desired shape, the final shape or the finished shape of the material is obtained by permanently deforming the material or by plastically deforming the material. Now, how it is plastically deformed, you have studied in strength of material. By applying the load, by introducing the stress in the material, sigma induced, that is greater than yield stress and less than ultimate stress. Whenever you apply the load greater than yield strength, and whenever the stress induced in the material will be greater than yield strength and less than the ultimate strength, then you can say what? The stress induced, then you can say it is a metal forming process and permanent deformation takes place. Later we will discuss. Now let's see the classification only. In metal forming, it is classified into two parts on the basis of availability of the material. If the availability of material is in the bulk form, then it is called bulk forming. And if the availability of the material in the sheet form, then it is called sheet forming. Now, this is your, the first one is your bulk forming, and the second one is your sheet forming. Bulk forming or sheet forming. The example of bulk forming processes are the first one is your rolling process. Rolling is the bulk forming example. Second one is your rolling and second one is your extrusion process. Third one is your wire drawing process, and fourth one is your forging process. So these are your bulk forming process, which I will discuss you in metal forming. And in sheet metal forming operation, we have the first one is your punching or piercing. It is a process of producing hole. The definition I will discuss later whenever I start this chapter. Punching, piercing, then blanking. And next, punching, piercing, blanking, and deep drawing or cup drawing. This is your deep drawing or cup drawing. Deep drawing or cup drawing, and next is your bending, embossing, and spinning, embossing, coining, embossing, spinning. These are the basics, your spinning. These are your spinning. these are your sheet metal forming operation in which the raw material is in the form of sheet. Okay. Now the next discussion is your metal cutting operations or machining operations. Actually, this classification is very large. That's why we can write it like metal cutting operation. 1 minute. That is your metal cutting operation. Metal cutting operation, metal cutting process, operation, similar words it are, metal cutting process or machining process or machining process. It is classified into three parts. Metal cutting or machining. First, let me define what is machining process. Actually, machining is a manufacturing process in which the unwanted material, the extra material, is removed with the help of a cutting tool in the form of chips. Therefore, it is known as the negative process because the material removal takes place here. So, it is called a negative process. It is called a negative process. Because material removal takes place. And welding is called positive process because material addition takes place there, material joining takes place. And it is called your zero process because there is no material removal and you can apply the conservation of volume here. Therefore, it is called zero process. We can use the conservation of volume technique. Because no material is added and no material is removed. Only the desired shape of the material is changed. If your initial material is cuboid, by applying a load, you can convert into a cube. But the volume will remain same. Now, this is classified into three parts. The first one is your conventional machining technique. First one is your conventional machining. Conventional machining or non-traditional machining, traditional machining. And secondly, it is classified into non-conventional machining technique. This is your non-conventional machining technique. Non-conventional machining. Or non-traditional machining. Non-traditional machining. Actually, let me erase this metal forming classification. I hope you have understood how the metal forming is classified. I will discuss your rolling, extrusion, wire drawing, forging, punching, blanking. On each and every processes, there will be numerical, and in gate, you can expect numerical from any of these metal forming processes. Okay. Just remember which is sheet forming and which one is the bulk forming. Now, how the conventional machining is classified? You know the conventional machining that is done on lathe with the help of milling cutter, drilling machines. It is classified into, you know very well, that is your, the first one is your turning. Turning is very famous machining process. By this we reduce the diameter of the shaft or workpiece. Second one is your taper turning. Taper turning. and third one is your facing. Facing is a finishing operation in which the surface is finished or the material is removed at the cross section. This is facing. And next one is the cutting, orthogonal cutting, slotting, and knurling. Actually knurling is not a machining process, because machining is a negative process, but in knurling material is not removed, it is only used to create the grip by applying a compressive load on the material to make the grip on the pencils, on the micrometer, on the different instruments, to increase the friction, to minimize the slip between the hand and the workpiece. That's why it is used to make the grips and impressions only. Here material is not removed, but it is studied in machining process, because it is done on lathe, and lathe is a machine tool. That's why knurling is studied in machining process, but it is not a machining operation. Okay, make it very clear. In this, there will be no material removal. Only in knurling, material removal does not take place. Only the material is compressed. The material is stressed, compressed with the help of a cutting tool. Okay, and your threading. And the next your classification is threading, and the next classifications are, you know, drilling, boring, counter boring, and next countersinking, and next are what next? That is your boring, countersinking, and milling, hobbing, okay, and next one is your surface finishing operations are also there. That is reaming, grinding, and reaming, grinding, and honing. These are the super finishing operation. Lapping, honing are the super finishing operation. In this, abrasive tools are used. And the last one is your shaping, planing. Various operations are there, various processes are there. That is the conventional machining and the traditional machining process. We will discuss one by one. It's not possible for us to discuss each and every operations. We will discuss you the turning process, the taper turning process, the facing, one question by orthogonal cutting, slotting one question, and then drilling. Then I will discuss you the milling process, and then shaping, planing, and the last one, that will be the grinding. So I will discuss you this conventional machining process. Okay, we will discuss the remaining conventional machining process in theoretically. Okay, and but conceptually, as well as we will do the numericals of all the star marked manufacturing, all the star marked machining processes. Now the second one is your non-conventional machining process. So here in non-conventional machining process, we have, that is your very important, that is The first one is your P, that is plasma arc machining. Plasma arc machining, that is non-conventional machining process. Why this non-conventional machining is required? This non-conventional machining is required because there is one of the very major concern in the conventional machining process, the tool wear. Tool wear takes place, very high tool wear takes place, due to which the tool life decreases. Therefore, the major concern of this process is the tool life. But in this case, the non-conventional machining process minimizes the tool wear. And in certain non-conventional machining operation, the tool wear is zero, like in ECM. That's why it has advantage over the conventional machining process. And by using the non-conventional machining process, we can machine even very brittle material, very hard material. We can machine the brittle and hard material very easily by using this. Okay. And plasma arc machining, second one is your electrochemical machining, that is your ECM, and next one is D, that is electrode discharge machining, that is your EDM, electrode discharge machining. And last one is your ultrasonic machining, USM. And then the fifth one is your abrasive jet machining. With the help of abrasive jet, this machining is done, AJM, abrasive jet machining. And the next is your abrasive jet machining and abrasive water jet machining, that is abrasive water jet machining, that is AWJM, abrasive water jet machining. And B, that is laser, that is electron beam machining. Electron beam machining, that is EBM, electron beam machining. And last one is the laser beam machining, LBM. Here this is the PCDSBB. You just remember this PCDSBB. Actually, one term I will define in the machining, that is the MRR, that is the material removal rate, the rate at which the material is removed. Here the MRR value, the material removal rate, is when you goes from bottom to top, the material removal rate value increases. Therefore, the laser beam machining will have the least MRR, and the plasma arc machining will have the maximum MRR. I have not included this abrasive jet machining and abrasive water jet machining because it depends upon the concentration of the abrasives. If the concentration of abrasive will be very high, then the MRR will be high, and if the concentration of abrasive will be low, then MRR will be low. That's why I have included only PCDSBB, plasma arc machining having very high, and the laser beam machining will be least MRR. And the last machining process we have, that is your This is your advanced machining process. In this advanced machining, we will study the NC machining, numerically control machining, and the CNC machining. Okay. So here in this, we will study the NC machining, NC, that is the numerically control machining. And second, we will study the CNC, that is the computer numerical control machining. So these are the basic machining topics which we will discuss. In the advanced machining, we will also discuss the programming, the languages, the important codes, G codes and M code, G01, G02, M01, M02, and the stepper motors, the BLU, basic length units. So these are the basic terms we will discuss in the machining process. Hope you guys have understood the classification of machining process. It is a negative process. It is a manufacturing process in which the desired shape of the final product is obtained by removing the excess material in the form of chips with the help of a cutting tool. It is of three types. One is the conventional machining. Second one is the non-conventional machining. The conventional machining is also called traditional machining. And non-conventional machining is called non-traditional machining. This conventional machining is classified into these various types of processes. Further, in machining, we will classify it on the basis of single point cutting tool, multi point cutting tool, orthogonal machining, oblique machining, and on the basis of the relative motion of the cutting tool, rotary motion, reciprocating motion. And these are the basic non-conventional machining technique, and these are your advanced machining technique. Hope you guys have understood this classification of metal cutting process. Okay. So last one is the metal joining process and its classification. Last one is your metal joining and its classification. So these are the actually syllabus which we have to study. That's why I have classified the whole manufacturing processes, so that you can understand what you have to study and what you have to omit. Okay. See, the last one is your metal joining process or welding. What is this metal joining process? Before starting the metal joining process, the classification of metal joining process, let's take a break, and after the break we will continue. Okay.